Hello again! Back in the clock with more of The Senate by F7. Time to go to Melon Mountains 4. Or maybe it's Gerudo Valley. We'll figure it out. This is a song I haven't heard ported very often. Ah, missed the coin. Oh well. Just reduces the temptation to go after more of them. I was perfectly safe, but I had to be a fool. Enemy warfare. Using my own enemies against them. And Mario's aim proves to be good once again. Mines. That's something you don't see a whole lot of. Seems like they just don't get a lot of attention or appearances. Of course, that might be because they're kind of limited in what you can do with them. Why was there a single coin there? Chuck, you can just keep digging all you want. I'm gonna just be over here. Ow. Oh, jeez, how did I survive? Has gone kind of funky as well. So, I'm getting out of there just in time, because things are getting a little bit hairy. And we have Melon Mountains 5, which has two exits. So, let's go find them both. To be another upward level. Ooh. With jigsaws. Okay, this is slightly visually confusing. Ow. Didn't even need that platform after a little bit. It's kind of weird to have it all go so far, but how in... Okay. Oh, that's it. Ugh. I somehow think I didn't quite do that the correct way. Just a hunch. No screen wrap either. I guess this game does not have that kind of technology. But it has the technology to create unholy abominations of double-headed saws. Those saws are so impractical. How would you hold them? How about I hold onto a mushroom for more than 2 seconds? It'd be nice, wouldn't it? Thank you. just taking all sorts of damage here that I don't need to be taken. I'm nearly killing myself for a coin because, you know, what would my life be like if greed wasn't the death of me? It's one of these sections. Trying to predict where the saws are gonna be. Ugh, and just kind of avoid everything ever. I can get behind avoiding everything ever. It's actually kind of a short stage. Oh wait, but there was a secret exit. Oh, dang. Well, it's the secret exit is just going to be a shortcut to the castle, so I'm not missing out on too much, but I gotta get it anyway. Here. Yes, that's where I missed. Seriously? I took a hit there! Pendulum Castle. That's unusual. Okay, let's go to Melon Mountain 6. Okay. I think this music is from the second Relay project. This is not. This music is from Mega Man 2, except it's a fairly poor port of it. I'm having some issues with the music in this game. Maybe you want to... I don't know if it's because of the emulator I'm playing it on or not. As you can probably tell, I use ZSNES. It is the one which is used most often and seems to have the most compatibility with games. But it has some issues. And yes, I was fairly sure that, given that there's no secret exit, the piece which was meant for here and not somewhere else in the stage. I've considered switching emulators, but a ZSNES seems to be the only one that has a proper fast forward and reverse. Come on, I was holding the Y button there. As I was saying, the CSNES seems to be the only one that has a proper fast forward and reverse that works pretty well. So, I tend to like those tools, even if, I try not to use them in regular gameplay, for the most part. Ah, star. Been a while since I've seen one of those. But I'm not gonna get an extra life out of it because I was a little bit too slow. And all of a sudden, something completely different. Dang it! I wanted to take advantage of that shell. I wanted to use the transmuting powers of finishing up a stage to gain myself something useful. It's been... three levels in over 10 minutes, but... you know what? It's the end of World 6, let's just do it. Pendulum Castle. Go! Did you think I would let you pass this easily, Mario? All your trouble will be worth nothing. You will never defeat the great Ajax. Ajax. Gotta be a reference to some sort of Greek mythology, but, exact... not rhythm. Don't exactly remember where Ajax was. Oop. Well, they did call it the Pendulum Castle. I suppose I was kind of expecting Pendulum. I don't get those, wooden stakes, really. The damage box on them seems to be kind of very wonky. Not that that's a bad thing, necessarily, because it usually actually works out in your favor, unlike most of the things where your hitbox, where the hitboxes are wonky. I need a P-switch. I see a P-switch. I get to the P-switch. That's how. Don't go in the door! I really am surprised by how often I'm staying alive in cases where I feel like I should be in a lot of trouble. Maybe I'm actually getting semi-halfway decent at these games. That'd be something, wouldn't it? Come see Doc, he actually has a modicum of skill. I'm wasting so much time on a P-switch run. It's gonna kill me, isn't it? Well, I got close to it. Forced me to miss out on a power bracelet coin. Oh no, whatever shall I do? The stakes were high, but that was why they didn't hit me, they were too high. Or otherwise out of position. Guess it went remarkably well. Ajax! Did you really think I would let you pass this easily, Mario? You would never defeat the great Ajax! You said that already. Okay. Use invincibility frames. Two hits! That's all you took was two hits. Dude, if you can't even attrition me, you got problems. Peace has restored once again in the Melon Mountains, now Ajax is defeated by Mario. Proofreading is non-existent in this clause. I hope you have enough warm clothes with you, Mario, as the apple snow caps can be freezing to say the least. Due to a weird glitch, the castle will not be destroyed. I'm sorry for the inconvenience. That's inconvenient. How? I don't know why it's the castle isn't destructible, but whatever. It doesn't really matter. It doesn't change anything. Oh, and that will take us to World 7, but we'll do that another time. That's all for me for now. Until then, this is Doc. I'll see you later.